Jessica, it was anybody's game up until the last 2 minutes. What made the difference there in those final couple minutes for you guys?
I think we got stops towards the end of the game. Obviously, the game was ugly. I mean, we knew that playing it, but we got stops when it mattered. It was a close game throughout the whole 40 minutes, and we knew that they were a tough team, but we got stops and converted.
Jamie, sometimes you have to win ugly in the SEC. Did the freshmen, you think, get an eyeful of just what a battle this league will be night in and night out with this game, you think?
I mean, a glimpse. We still have a lot of games. We're not even halfway through the season yet, or a quarter. So, I mean, they got a glimpse of it. That's every game, though. Every team that you play is tough. Every team is going to try to beat us. We're ranked pretty high, and every team is going to come into games against us wanting to beat us. So, I mean, we just have to understand that and never take games off.
Lauren and then Luke in the back.
Were the 28 turnovers y'all trying to do too much, or was that just their press?
We knew they were tough defensively. They pressed the entire game from tip to finish. We knew that they were going to do that. I think we just need to work on it. But we haven't really seen someone press that much, and they're pretty athletic, so I think we just need to work on it. It's something that we haven't really seen in our postseason.
Jamie, back here. Can you kind of speak to Avina's ability to turn things around there in the second half and make some really important shots for you guys in some plays down the stretch there?
Yeah, she came in and made big shots. I mean, we've seen that from her, and she just came in ready. It didn't really affect the rest of the game, or didn't let the rest of the game affect her, and came in and made big plays for us. So, I mean, we need that. We understand it. We see it every day in practice, and she's capable of making big plays like that.
Dan?
Likewise, could you just talk about the play Annie made there in the fourth quarter? She goes into that corner, saves that pass, looked like it was going out of bounds, and then sets up Avina for the basket that gave you the lead for good. I mean, how big was that play? Because it was kind of almost was like another turnover, and it turns into a huge play for you guys.
Yeah, they played well off each other. Obviously, Annie made a big save for us because the ball's going out, and then she made a good pass. We know she's a great passer, and she found somebody who was hot at the time. So, I mean, they're just playing smart or hustling at the end of the game.
Lauren, in the back.
How impressive is it for such young freshmen to be able to have that short-term memory when that first quarter with all the turnovers, I mean, really the turnovers of the game, but that but in the first quarter where you're kind of like, oh my gosh, this press is for real, to be able to put that behind you and play your game?
I mean, it's good. You have to have that each game. You can't let past plays affect the way you're playing, or else you're going to have a rough game and rough games to come. So, I mean, that's just something that we take pride on, and helping each other, not letting people get down on themselves, and just understanding that we all make mistakes. We make a bunch of mistakes ourselves. So, I think just staying together and helping one another, and just staying tough the whole game is something that we think is important for our team.
At this point, we'll let Jamie. Questions for Anastasia, please. Lauren, and then Dan.
Anastasia, will you just talk about that play where you used all of your body to get it in the pass to Avina?
I guess I just used my athleticism. It was a big moment, and I was trying to get, even if it was going out of bounds, I was going to try to hustle to make it not go out of bounds. And, you know, I just drove to the rim, and I seen Avina open, and I just dished it to her. Playing hard.
Dan. Avina, McKay was in here talking about, you know, their impression, saying that there's no way a first-year player, you know, can be ready for that. There's no way you can simulate what they do. What was it like playing against that kind of pressure?
Honestly, it's just basketball. You know, coming from high school, AU, whatever. We're used to getting pressed like that. Obviously, the college game is a lot different. But it's something that we prepared for in practice. We just have to do a better job of coming in and just really focusing.
Will and Steve.
Avina, it was mentioned earlier, but you hit three really big shots at the end of the game there to kind of spark your team and really push ahead. What was going through your mind when you made those plays? Were you confident? How were you feeling?
Yeah, I mean, it just kind of happened. I was open, so I shot it. And once the first one went in, the second one is kind of just became a rhythm for me. So I am confident making big plays for my team. I know my team is confident in me, so just
for being a game, I mean, I know you were struggling with turnovers much of the game. How do you not let that impact other? I mean, because obviously you were shooting really well, even though you had some turnovers. How do you not let one part of the game impact another?
Yeah, I mean, personally, the amount of turnovers I have is unacceptable. You know, and I had talked to Coach after the game about it, but it's something that I have to move past as being a point guard. And so as Andy, we can't let one play affect us. We have to bounce back because our team is counting on us.
Avina, how does it feel to be able to finish the game on such a positive note, especially that final three-pointer seemed like you were really feeling it, the team was feeling it. Just how does it feel to be able to end on that kind of note?
I mean, it feels good to end on a win, but at the same time, we played terrible. Definitely not what we're capable of, but at the same time, we'll bounce back.
Anastasia, the big block by Mercedes near the end, you got the ball and just shot out like a cannon for the other end. Did you know at that point you're going right to the rim? And then how much did the crowd get you guys back in that game in that last 2 minutes too?
Yeah, the crowd was really good. You know, that gets us going. And when she made that block, I don't know, I just got the ball and I just used my speed. And yeah, when she did that, I knew I was going right to the rim. And I knew that I had to finish, and I finished and got the and one. So yeah, I knew that was a big moment.
Tyler and then Dan, please.
For either player, obviously Auburn started a three-guard lineup. Do you feel like that their speed and athleticism affected y'all in a certain way? Did that make the game harder to win?
Honestly, I think we were definitely our own enemies out there. We're just turning it over unnecessarily, and that's just not how we play. So really, I wouldn't even say it's the defense. It was just us just making unnecessary passes and just not being smart with the ball.
Dan, then Laura, back.
Anastasia, could you also address what it was like to go against their pressure, but then also to kind of play through the rough spots and finish the way you guys did?
Yeah, they play really good defense, and we knew that coming in, but yeah, we just had to, like, when we first got in, you know, they were, you know, getting steals and stuff, but like Avina said, we just got to get past it and forget about that and keep going and keep playing. So.
Lauren, in the back of the room.
Anastasia, how important were the seniors, you know, Jamie and Mercedes, to keep you guys focused when the shots weren't coming and you guys were turning it over the backcourt a lot? How important were they to kind of center you all during the timeouts?
Yeah, they were very important. They kept telling us to, you know, they never, like, was negative. They were always positive the whole time. And being freshmen, that's what you need from your seniors, and them believing in us and telling us to keep pushing and we're still in this, you know, that felt really good. So.
Any final questions? Dan?
I mean, they had 79 shots, but only shot like 31% from the floor. How much do you think your defense may have affected them?
As a team?
Yeah.
But just overall, our defense wasn't all the way there, but just making big plays down the stretch is really working in our favor. Obviously, boxing out is a huge one we still need to continue to work on. But just overall, we just need to get better defensively. Offensively, obviously, wasn't our best game, but we'll be better.